Comes in on Sunday. Tonight we're looking at the work of the Roy Castle Lung Cancer Foundation in Liverpool. All the experts agree that smokers are at the most risk from the disease.
Merseyside has the highest number of deaths in England, and the northwest as a whole is well above the national average. Anne O'Connor has been looking at the legacy Roy left behind.
Before Roy Castle, many of us had simply never heard of passive smoking. The entertainer, who said he'd smoked half a cigarette in his entire life, blamed his lung cancer on years of performing in smoky clubs. Barely able to walk, he travelled Britain raising cash for a cause he knew could never help him.
40,000 people are going to get lung cancer every year. And we're doing nothing about it because we haven't got a lung cancer centre anywhere in the world.
He was dying. He was a few weeks from death. He knew he was dying. He knew why he was dying. But in his courage, and he was an absolute hero, he went around the country demonstrating to people exactly what would happen as a result of smoking cigarettes and as a result of secondhand smoke.
Surgeon Professor Ray Donnelly also dreamed of a research centre in Liverpool, then known as the lung cancer capital of Europe. Roy didn't live to see their dream come true. Cliff Richard opened the Roy Castle Lung Cancer Foundation in 1998, 4 years after his friend's death. Roy's wife Fiona was there to see the £12 million building. The aim is simple but ambitious: to find a cure. So today, 7,500 people considered to be at risk of lung cancer are being carefully monitored by researchers in the Liverpool Lung Project. They're analysing everything about them: where they live, what they eat, where they work and how they relax. A massive study over decades to try to find out how and why lung cancer develops.
The labs here are being renovated to accommodate even more research, but the figures remain frightening. Liverpool and Glasgow are still top of the league of lung cancer cases in Britain. One in five smokers will contract the disease, and several hundred people who've never smoked will also get it.
Very much neglected, very negative attitudes amongst doctors, nurses, politicians, administrators, even patients themselves. And we have managed to turn that around to a large extent, so that lung cancer is now very high on the public health agenda, which is where it should be, because it is the most common cause of death, of cancer death, in both men and in women. Dedication,
dedication, that's what you need. The Record Breakers presenter's signature tune's been re-recorded by his co-presenter, Bucks Fizz star Cheryl Baker. The foundation's using it as a mobile ringtone to encourage 100,000 smokers to give up on July the 1st. Roy's memory hopefully helping create another record.
Roy, if he's here today, would be absolutely over the moon and thrilled to bits with this new legislation. And I think he, more than anyone, brought it to the national consciousness, this problem of passive smoking. And everyone remembers the images and the pictures of Roy, and we have so much to be grateful to him for. Dedication's what
you need. Anne O'Connor, Granada Reports, Liverpool.
Sport now. Manchester City's wait for the manager is over, it seems. Here's Chris.
Yes, thank you. Well, they've been linked with just about every manager in Europe since...